Bro, you're a complete liar.
Whoa, come on. Did my mantra fail you?
Fail me? My foot! Look at this mess. Current sources, resistors, all parallel.
You're just using the wrong tool. Master Thévenin has a fellow apprentice named Norton.
Don't trick me. Norton? You mean the antivirus software?
This Master Norton is a wizard at circuit simplification.
Simplification again?
Listen up. Here is the Norton mantra. Connect to C amps, extinguish to find ohms.
Connect to C amps. Does connect mean short circuiting? Won't it blow up?
We're solving it on paper, not in the lab. It won't blow up. We can turn any complex linear circuit into one current source parallel with one resistor. Connect means you take the low terminals and short them with a wire.
Wait, extinguish to find ohms? I know this one. Kill the voltage source, aka short circuit. Kill the current source, aka open circuit. It's the exact same resistance as Thévenin.
Bingo.
Oh, I get it. If I short the terminals, the resistance becomes zero. Current takes the path of least resistance. So the short circuit current, ISC, is the Norton current, IN. Norton is a genius.
Now, let's crush the headache of a circuit. With Norton, watch the speed. Step 1. Connect to C amps. Short the low terminals. Current from the left, 10 volts over 2 ohms is 5 amps. Plus 3 amps from the middle. Total is 8 amps.
Whoa, just like that?
Step 2. Extinguish to find ohms. Kill the 10-volt source. Kill the 3-amp source. Looking back, we only see the 2-ohm resistor. Done deal. Want the current through the 5-ohm load? Current divider rule. 8 amps times 2 divided by 2 plus 5. Roughly 2.29 amps.
Oh my god, that is way faster than calculating VTH.
Just remember, it only works for linear circuits.